I got, you know, a good 3 inches underneath it. So what I'm doing is I'm heating it up so that it hopefully just induces a little contraction on this side and keeps this bend that we have in it. I'm only doing this at every 6 foot intervals. I'll take a look and see what it does after that, and then I'll decide if I need to come back and do the 3 foot. Probably do, but I don't want to start there.
Okay, that's it. And I'm thinking this is looking pretty good because the heated area is primarily on the top, and so that'll cause it to contract right there, which is what we want it to do. But can't do anything more now. I'm just going to let it cool down. We'll check it tomorrow.
Yeah, that'll do. I'm going to
try and fold
that horsepower up a little.
Hey,
Doug?
Yeah?
Found it.
All right.
So we take that chain off. Mikey.
This is our dip for the Super Bowl.
Is this Super Bowl day yet? Is this Super Bowl today or tomorrow?
Tomorrow.
Okay, you're good. Mark, go ahead and pull that out. Drew, turn the gas off. And Mark, you can pitch that wheel. So if he needs more help, then you use the wheel.
Great.
Otherwise, yeah, you're calling it. All right. I'm ready. Somebody said we ought to put a little soldier down in there. That ought to be a pretty good idea. Pull it faster.
Faster. That's good right there. Okay. Hold still. And more. Beautiful. Very good. All right, that's enough.
And we'll let that. All right, let's drop this lead way down. Now, I want to do this, nobody else, because this is going to splash like hell.
Nasty?
Yeah. Okay, everybody back. Ready? Ready to run?
Yeah.
Okay. Here we go, come here.
Did he get you?
No. Yeah, that worked good.
Did he? I thought something.
Now that'll cool it down really quick. Keep it from heating the steel up.
Yeah, that's what I mean. I seen it. See ya. That's why I ran.
Okay, now let's go with the rest. Yeah, that's good.
Man, it cools so fast on the side.
Yeah, it really does. And have that big block of cold lead in there. That breaks down really fast. All right, that's good. We got plenty in the bottom here to start the next melt. Looking good. Going forward, another foot.
I think he's hitting the trouble.
There you go. That's good. Hang right there. You tell these guys are done. Okay, good. Throw that chalk under the wheels right there.
Good, come your way. Starboard.
Yeah. Did it come back to board plumb?
It says it's here. He's got another one outside.
Okay.
Hold out. I'm happy with that. First, I was kind of happy before we started doing any of it. Now I'm really happy. Right over if we need to. We can put a crowbar in here. You're good. You can come out. Thank you. Lunch coming.
Cover that.
Yeah, I'm gonna go down and cut a piece of steel to go in that gap.
Okay.
But you can get it tacked up on that side, please. Well, that's looking good. Mm-hmm. You do fine work.
Oh, it's crooked.
Crowbar.
Perfect.
Now, I think what I want to do, once we get some lead flowing in there, is jostle it like that and then pull the crowbar out.
Okay.
Looking good.
Of it would be, and that's about where I expected it to be. Like the Brett Harp gets. Yeah, look how the side bowed in a little bit. Well, I mean, they just have lid piled up on it. Yeah, but I don't want to hit it now with the torch, because it'll do the same thing it did last time. It just gets too hot. Yeah, see how it bowed in right there?
Wow.
That's from the heat. But it's all cool because it bowed in and not outward. Yeah, that'll do for now. 2,500 pounds of lead.
5,500.
Done.
232 pounds.
Done, son.
Wow.
That's how they do it.
221.
221.
Yeah, go ahead. Does it look all right on you? Just the very bottom. Will you give me a hammer?
Yeah.
And we can beat it in at the top there.
Yeah, I got it. Yeah.
We can just drill a hole in it out here and pull it out.
Earth.
Ideas? Oil? Painted on the inside.
Easy?
Yeah.
That because it's in the pintle. Wow. It's got 5 inches, it's taking all the strain out.
That's great.
Okay. Well done, thanks.
How's it going?
Good.
Looks kind of smoky back in there.
Yeah.
Looking good. I think we lost a welder this morning. Another one. A Lincoln first, now a Miller.
Yeah. Yeah, you shouldn't be able to do that with 10 volts. You shouldn't be able to drill holes.
No. There is something definitely wrong with it.
Yeah.
It's nuts.
It's gotta be something in the voltage regulation, so.
Most of it must be inside that solid housing there. Oh, there's the big old capacitors right there. Jesus, they're huge. These two right here, they're there.
Oh, yeah, those are.
Back behind and underneath.
Yeah, there they are, okay.
Yeah, tucked in.
They don't look fucked or nothing to me. They're not bloated.
No smoke. I'll take it to them, see what they say.
Yeah, that's gonna cover it up. Barely, it'll do it. Sweet. Perfect.
In there. I'm just put all that down to a puddle.
Here's the one we did yesterday. You can see that there's a nice gap along that outside where that steel had flexed inward, then cooled off and went back out.
We'll probably pour tar or epoxy or something like that down in there after the steel plates welded on top of these. So what happens next is we gotta cut and weld steel plates to go here. Yeah, we could do that. We can cut weld steel. We can cut steel plates. No welder today. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna wait for this one to cool down, and then we'll go back in there with a torch and melt this stuff that splattered on the wall out down into a top of it. And that'll have us two done.
Now here's what it's doing to the outside of our boat. It is bending it, and I'm not crazy about it, but it's not horrible. This is the plate that's still hot, and it is actually sucked in, so it should come back. This one was done the same way, and it's back much better than it was. You can tell because you can see the burned areas where it kind of scorches the rust out here. But that section is darker, this section is darker, and see, this is where it hadn't been poured yet. That's the next section we're gonna do. We gotta do 2,500 pounds there and then 2,500 pounds down here. But, you know, it's not bad. Yeah, the fish won't care.
Okay, there's still some.
An inch?
Yeah. Okay. One more.
We're okay. We'll pick them off the ground a little bit.
We're making talk of you.
What? Yes.
What do you make a ton of?
Yeah, why don't we just do that and we'll watch what it touches. What do you got, a quarter inch maybe?
Yeah, that much.
Yeah, quarter inch. 5 millimeters?
Probably, yeah.
This downturn that good?
We had 13,000 last year, and we're expecting down to 16,000 this year.
Okay.
Yeah, that's looking good. Well, we're going to have to patch our hole up. We got a little carried away there, but that's not too hard to do. We can cut and weld aluminum. But now his hands are touching, his head's really close. And so we're thinking about just using some fiberglass to fill in the gap there instead of cutting his head down. We're going to see about that. His hand out here is right up against the wall. And it brings him up to the height he's supposed to be at. Make a dike around the outside. And touch the clay to the ceiling. You know, while I'm holding him up, you can do that. Then we'll take him down and we'll build it up to the height, to the level of the clay. You go a step down. Doctor? Yeah, I didn't mix that too rich. I'll give it another 30 minutes.
Well, no, I'm hoping they're gonna, mosquitoes will go to the horses now. They'll go, ooh, look.
Ready arc where I buy these machines, and David here has found the problem and nothing flat. There's a couple of loose connections in on those lugs back where we plug our cables in. We've wiggled them so much that the voltage sense wires are off, which kind of makes sense because that'd be why I'd be trying to up the voltage continuously until it's blowing holes through the steel. We must have just wiggled them loose by plugging things in and out.
Yeah.
We need one of those when our power's on, huh?
403.
Yeah.
And this is reading 5.7.
Well, good news about the welder. We're back from the store and he replaced the capacitor too. And she is back where she belongs. Should be in top functioning order. Gotta say a really nice thank you to the guys at Ready Arc. They have, you know, if you're looking for a welder use, they prorate their welders, their used equipment, so that you can buy them used there, and I've had great luck with them, you know, especially because they fix them cheap. And we just got the Dragons back down off the boat. Now they're ready for paint. Well, at least the one on this side. We still got to mount the one on the other side, but we'll be better at it now. And see, what we're going to do is we're going to cut a hole through the roof right there, and those mounting bolts, the holes are there, so we know where to do that. And that's where his head connects and collects the rainwater off the top of the boat. So that came out real well. We're looking forward to getting him up and permanently mounted. And the catwalks are coming along. Mark has all the braces cut, so we'll be putting those in this next weekend. And we've got 10,000 pounds, no, 5,000 pounds of lead now poured in down in the keels. That'd be a quarter of what we got to do. We've moved a bunch more in, so. With the welder fixed, we'll be able to put a bracket on the side and keep going with that project. It's flag replacement day. We have a good culture behind our flag in the United States, if nothing else.
Yeah, no.
You want to piss people off, treat one of these wrong. Which is really weird because we're a country of freedoms, right? Yeah. Except when it comes to the flag, then you have no freedoms. I don't get it. I tried to understand it. I just, beyond me. We actually wig out. And we've been playing around in the pilot house, laying out where things might go and just using cribbing blocks to give us an idea. But Mark has done us up a sketch in SketchUp. I'll show you that. So here's what he's been working on, and you can see that is pilot house looking stuff. Oh, very nice. We'll put this online when he's done with it. You can get this off our blog page. I'll put it somewhere on the website, svseeker.com.
I'll probably put a link to it from Facebook too. We're SV Seeker there as well.
Now for a bit of shameless promotion. If you have more money than you know what to do with, or you are smart enough not to buy lottery tickets, we have caps for sale. Now this one takes a little bit of, you gotta let go of a little ego to wear it. Or if you don't can't do that, then you can give this one to a friend. And nothing like a nice steaming cup of coffee from a Seeker mug. And just a reminder to you too, get out there.